Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. As you noticed, you got plopped out over here, which is a pretty nice place to get plopped out after the dungeon, because where we have to go next is to Hyrule Field, which is right through here, past the oil guy. Speaking of, let's see if he has anything to say to us. I think it's pretty good at the moment, and no, not right now, actually. And... yep. Okie dokie, I guess that's it. Oh, I should also mention this. This soup right here, this is pretty funny, actually. I should probably show this off. First, I'll just refill my lantern. So I got an empty bottle. I'm not going to be using the lantern for a while again, but first, you can try scooping this, but he'll be like, oh, you can. If you want to take it, guy, you have to heat it and make it safe. So now you use a lantern. Did I? Oh, I did light it. That's weird. Now, scoop the soup. You put nasty soup in the bottle. This is Koro's special recipe. Now, this is rather interesting here. So, if you take some of the soup, or I should say, if you drink the soup, it'll cause you damage. That's just something that I always found funny, is that the soup is so bad that it actually causes you issues. Anyway, now you'll notice that the gate is open over here, so go right through it, and... new place! I believe there's gonna be a little cutscene coming up to show the area and whatnot. You! I'm going to kill you as well, just because I can. Should I be waiting for some of these drops? Probably not, because my wallet's almost full anyway. Speaking of, there's actually something that I should grab in the field before I go up to the gorge, the next area. I forgot the name of that gorge area. I'm sure I'll see it when I get there. You know, my memory is terrible when it comes to names. By the way, these critters, they drop... I forgot their names. They drop these nuts that hurt if you walk into them. The easiest way to deal with them is to do that, and, well, just sort of stun them with that, and then attack them like so. Otherwise, they're too fast for you to get them. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do here is, you see that dot on the tree? That is a golden bug. There are 20 of them in the game world. I'm only going to be collecting this one for a certain reason, which I'll get to a little bit later. But for now, I'm going to pick up this one. I'm going to cover all these in one single video much, much later on in the walkthrough. But for now, you want to get at least one bug. As I said, you'll see why when I get there. The next thing is that there is a heart piece in one of these trees, and I always forget which tree it is. That's kind of a problem. So, I'm going to randomly wander this area and hope that I come across the heart piece. I think it's one of the ones on this side. Just gotta look up into the branches and hopefully the branches won't obscure my vision to the heart piece and something's coming towards me because I hear the music changing. Maybe I have to go up here, I'm not sure. Maybe it would be easier to tell when it's dark, as you can see it's turning into nighttime by the time I'm getting through this. Night and day goes by very quickly in Zelda world. wait, did I check this one? I don't remember if I checked. I could have swore it was one of the ones. There's just so many trees in this area that it's hard to remember just which one it is. Oh, I think that was the guy that made it trigger the danger sequence, or dangerous music. It's around here somewhere. I know it has to be. What is this blasphemy? I don't know. But it's just so hard to pick out from all the trees. Maybe it was one of these down there. Oh, first you've got to die, and preferably you too. Wait. There it is, right there. See that? There's the heart piece. Whip out the boomerang. lock onto the heart piece. Voila! One more for another heart container. Now we can finally move on, and it's raining. Which is no problem for Link, apparently, because he will come out completely dry no matter how wet he gets. He's apparently waterproof or something. Maybe he's got a lot of oil on him, you know, like ducks or something like that. Hey, who is this guy? Oh my goodness. That's actually exactly what I'm looking for. So, you are the postman. Do you have something for me? Oh, thank you very much. Well, his letter is pretty funny, actually. So I'm definitely going to go to the collection screen to check it out. Go, man, go! Deliver the mail of the people! And check your collection screen. Go to here, to the letters by pressing a plus button, and then going to here, you can click on letters to read them. If he has a letter for you, he will approach you at high speed. Do not fear, do not flee. Anyway, we just want to go up to this route. If you look, you can see the twilight all around the area. This is what it looks like from the outside, by the way, if you never checked that out before. It's a really, really looming dark cloud of death. But don't worry, we'll get through it. Anyway, you just want to go right down here, follow the path, and you'll meet up with the twilight. Eventually, this field is really big. I would have grabbed some of the grass to call Epona, I mean Anope, but the problem is that you can't call her at this point, and there's a reason for that, actually. Yes, I do. I'm not too worried. Yeah, sure. Let's go! Because there's pretty much nothing else we can do at this moment in time. Come on, Midna, suck me in. Well, pull me in. Yes. Whoop. Why did she have to do it so rough? Here we are, back in the twilight. Back as a wolf as well, as you might have guessed. Fetching. I do? Well, wolves are pretty. Alright, so just follow this path and you'll eventually come across something very familiar. Not Deku Baba's. Well, Shadow Deku Baba's. That's a wooden sword. Sniff it with the A button. He recognizes the scent of all of them. And you get the youth scent. This is, well, I guess sort of important. There really isn't any other pathway to go but forward, but if you use your senses, yeah, you'll be able to see a trail while you use your senses of that scent. It leads you eventually to the shadow beasts here, which I'm going to have to take care of. Now that I have my good old B button lock onto everything and kill them at once, dealio here, they are no trouble whatsoever. They are totally pathetic, actually. That one-shots a lot of shadow enemies, actually. But what is this? A missing bridge? What is this blasphemy? Who removes an entire bridge? This is just absolutely crazy. But wait, didn't we see a bridge before? Come on, zoom in. She's gonna do it for you, by the way. And those things that you've seen way up in the sky that the shadow creatures come from are called portals, as you've seen, and you can use them to warp all around the world, which is extremely handy to say the least. Well, whenever you unlock one of those portals, of course, you're gonna have to hoof it to each portal as you go. But the one you want to go to, I believe, is this one. I think you're gonna warp right next to it, actually. And it's funny, once you're outside the Twilight, you don't immediately transform back to your human form. But there's a reason for that, and you'll see why a little bit later. Just take note of this at the moment, that you cannot transform back to human form whenever you please. Now, oh! There's the bridge. You remember it now? Yeah, the bridge I said was just hilariously slapped here of all places. I'll go up next to it, press up. Indeed it is. Absolutely. And go to there. Kakariko Gorge. Ah, that was the name of the place, Kakariko Gorge. For some reason, I was thinking it was Elden Gorge earlier, but I didn't want to say it if I was wrong, so I just said it was the Gorge place. And yeah, that bridge that randomly popped up over here was taken down by the shadow creatures, which was why it was standing up over there on edge against the wall. This is the bridge that indeed goes here. In fact, even the arches match. Voila! Now we can move forward. Isn't that convenient? And there's a couple of times throughout the game that you're going to have to do stuff like this. So just memorize certain odd objects that you see along the way. Indeed. Put out your senses. And you notice that there wasn't any scent on the bridge because... I mean, there wasn't any scent on the bridge because of the fact that there was... You know, that bridge was way, way out of the way compared to where it was before. So they didn't really pass over it. Well, maybe they passed over it, but... Or maybe they jumped over the bridge or something like that. I'm actually unsure about that, now that I think about it a little more. Yeah, that sounds good to me. You don't even have to use your senses to dig at certain places. You can just dig right through it by pressing down. And these are shadow bokoblins, obviously. And shouldn't I just be using this? Yeah, that makes things so much easier. Hey, you. no drops? Okay. Moving on. Through here is our next destination. And it is a very important one. Kakariko Village. Now this looks like a whole different Kakariko Village than what you're used to in other Zelda games. Oh, here's a little puzzle for you. One of these is always further away than the other one, so it's impossible to lock onto all three at once here. So you have to lock onto... I didn't want to do that. Curses! So what you want to do is defeat the furthest away one first, and then the other two in one swipe. Just like... Come on, there we go. Wait, did I miss the other one somehow? How did I miss the other one? At least I'm not taking any damage, but still, it's really weird. Boop. Boop. There we go. See, was that so hard? There's another portal, which we'll be able to use to warp here later. I think this light is referring to me. Sounds good, but I think I'm going to be doing that in the next part. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you there.